1972 is now before us. It holds precious time in which to accomplish good for the nation. We must not waste it. Quietly today, when the last combat unit, Delta Company, 3rd Battalion, 21st Infantry, was deactivated. But until the final hours, Delta Company was on the job, patrolling the underbrush near Danang. While the outfit took some casualties, its men were warned in advance, no taking chances, no heroics.
Baby.
decisions by judges, some disappointments and petty mistakes, the Munich Olympics were on the way to becoming the pleasantest Olympics because the West Germans worked to make them so. Today, one observer gave them a new name, the Bloody Olympics. Altogether, 17 people were slaughtered yesterday, two in the Olympic Village and the other 15 in the shootout at the airport. We begin a program devoted almost entirely to the Munich atrocity with a report on the shootout last night. ABC's Lou Choppy was there.
Mama put your arm rolled out of bed and she ran to the police station. When the papa found out, he began to shout, he started the investigation. It's against the law, it was against the law. Oh, what your mama saw, it was against the law. And the mama looked down and spit on the ground every time the name gets mentioned. The cop said, oh, if I get that boy, I'm gonna stick him in the house of detention. Well, I'm on my way, I don't know where I'm going. I'm on my way, I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye to Rose, if the queen of Corona. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
Say this to the television audience. I made my mistakes. In all of my years of public life, I have never profited from public service. I've earned every cent. And in all of my years of public life, I have never obstructed justice. And I think, too, that I could say that I welcome this kind of examination because people have got to know whether or not their president is a crook. Well, I'm not a crook. I've earned everything I've got.
preparing the Sydney Opera House. Open.
Shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow. Vice President Ford will be sworn in as president at that hour in this
82. What finally brought the enfeebled old lion down was not announced. He's been very ill for years and has not, so far as is known, received any foreign visitors since June.
really think Elvis Presley died today. He was 42. Apparently it was a heart attack. He was found at his home in Memphis, not breathing. His road manager tried to revive him. He failed. A hospital tried to revive him. It failed. His doctor pronounced him dead at 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Run, run. members of the country rock group Lynyrd Skynyrd were among six people killed when a twin-engine plane crashed in a southeastern Mississippi swamp. The dead were lead singer Ronnie Van Zant, guitarist Steve Gaines, and Gaines' sister, vocalist Cassie Gaines. Authorities say it appears the pilot was trying to crash land the plane after running low on fuel but struck treetops near Macomb, Mississippi on the Louisiana border. The leader of the group, Van Zant, helped create country rock hits like Free Bird and Sweet Home Alabama. We'll be right back.
is the picture of the new Pope. Pope John Paul will shortly make his appearance there at St. Peter's balcony. The 264th pontiff of the Roman Catholic Church, the first ever in history from Poland, one of the most Catholic of all nations.
Considerable amount of time. A bonfire had been built in the middle of center field. Police tried to clear the unruly crowd, pushed them out, finally got them off the field, although, again, it took a long time. Perhaps some arrests, it's hard to tell. Some people appear to be taken into custody.
We've done it all before. to steal that. Has anyone got a torch? Ringo's got my baby.
If you've been anywhere near a television set or a radio these past few hours, you already know that John Lennon is dead. He was shot late this evening in front of his apartment building in New York City. The man who shot John Lennon walked up to the musician as he was leaving his limousine. Time has come. You've seen the map. We've looked at the figures, and NBC News now makes its projection for the presidency. We have projected Ronald Reagan the winner.
Washington Hilton Hotel this afternoon. The president was not hit. He was pushed into his limousine and immediately taken away to safety. However, three persons were hit. We believe they are two Secret Service agents and the president's press secretary, James Brady.
Now it's happened again. Less than 7 weeks ago, the President of the United States in the city of Washington. Today, the Pope in the eternal city of Rome. But now, at the end of this dreadful day, we can say this with certainty. The surgery on Pope John Paul was completed after 4 hours and 20 minutes. Hospital officials say the operation was successful. Vatican Radio says the Pope is not in serious condition.
latest music form created by artists, video music. And we've got it for you 24 hours a day right here on MTV.
Mr. Speaker, sir, the House meets this Saturday to respond to a situation of great gravity. We are here because for the first time for many years, British sovereign territory has been invaded by a foreign power. After several days of rising tension in our relations with Argentina, that country's armed forces attacked the Falkland Islands yesterday and established military control of the islands.
Now in Atlanta.
Researchers know of 413 people who have
contracted the condition in the past year. One-third have died and none have been cured. Researchers are now studying blood and other samples from the victims, trying to learn what is causing the disease. So far, they have had no luck.
So slashed and torn. Pressure.